Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I will show you how I did this. So last week I posted this video and I got a lot of questions asking, how can we do this? Well, today I will explain to you exactly how you can do this too. It's quite easy to do, but you need some singing or beatboxing skills to get good results. And you need to know some basic stuff in a DAW, like exporting samples to create an AI model. But first, to clear up some questions, it might look real time in my video. Unfortunately, it's not. Well, at least not yet, because I believe it's only a matter of time if we see how fast AI and machine learning is progressing. And the second question I saw a lot was if this is a plugin or is this Doubler 2 by Foglia. It is not. Doubler 2 is a cool plugin and you can do a lot of nice stuff with it, but what it basically does is converting audio signals into MIDI. And to get similar results like I have in my video, we need a little bit more than that. And that's where machine learning and AI comes in. So what did I use? Well, it's basically the same as cloning voices. Now, this is nothing new and has been around for a while. But the difference is, instead of making AI models from voices, we are going to make instrument models. Now, there are different websites and services where you can do this. Some of them are free, some of them are paid. It doesn't really matter which one you use, since they all use similar technology, I think the results will be the same. As long as you have the option to create your own AI model, you're good to go. So what I have been using in my videos is Musicfy. I've put a link in the description. When you click on it, you will get to this page. What Musicfy basically is you can transform your own voice into a different one, or you can train your own AI voices. When you click on it, you can try it out for free, but the only thing you can do is generate a limited amount of vocals. But what we need is to train our own AI model. And for that, we need a subscription. So the cheapest one is $10 a month. You have unlimited generation, standard speed, standard sounds, and this is the most important thing, one custom voice model. Now, there is a downside for this. If you want to train a new model, you have to delete the old one. But besides that, if you just want to try it out for a month, this one is good to go. Just be sure you click monthly right here. Otherwise, you have to pay for a whole year, and that's maybe not something you want to do if you just want to try it out. And guys, if you know better alternatives that's cheaper or even free, please let it know in the comments so everybody can check it out. Before we continue on Musicfy, we need to go back to our DAW to prepare some samples for our dataset to create our AI model. Now, what we basically need to do is get a bunch of samples of the instrument, put them all together and export it as one WAV file. There are some guidelines for this. It's best to use dry samples without any reverb or delay on it. Also, try to use different note ranges and articulations like slides and glides and long notes and short notes. This will all help to get more realistic results. And at last, you need at least 4 or 5 minutes of samples to get some decent results. Now, back in our DAW, I already prepared some samples. Today we are going to make a saxophone model. I don't own a saxophone, so I use some samples from a sample pack I bought. What we need to do is put them all together right here. It doesn't really matter in what order. Also, the spaces in between doesn't matter. Musicfy will handle all of that. It will sound something like this. So the next thing we need to do is export this as one WAV file. So back at Musicfy, you go to your dashboard, and as you can see, I've already created a bunch of models, but you are going to create your first one. You click here on new voice. You can give it a name. Let's give it a name, saxophone. Then you have a slider here where you can adjust the quality of your model. Higher quality models take longer to train. Now, I always do somewhere between 1 and 2 hours. Let's say 1 30. Here we upload our WAV file we just exported. And the next thing we only need to do is click start training. You get this message, you can just click confirm. And then it says training. Now, this is the only part that takes a little bit of time. Depending on the quality you have chosen, it can take up to 1 or 2 hours. When your model is done training, you see this green dot blinking and it says it's ready. What you need to do now is click on create track and we can start to have some fun. All you need to do now is record something and upload it right here, or you can record directly here in the browser. Okay, I'm going to try to sing something and see how that works out. Let me save this file in the background and then open it up right here. So this is the input file. Now what you can do is select the quality right here. If you're just trying stuff out, you can keep it on standard. And if you find the right take, you can click master and use that one. But for now, we're going to use the standard one and just click on remix. Now, usually this takes up about 20 seconds, sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little bit less. So when it's done processing, you will see this play button right here and this bar. And when you click on it, you will hear the result. As you can hear, that's not bad at all, and it sounds pretty cool. So a couple of tips. Sometimes it's important to try to mimic some characteristics or articulation of the particular instrument you're trying to sing. Another cool thing is you can also use any instrument you like instead of your voice. For example, we have this flute right here, and if I play something like this, let me quickly save this in the background and open it up right here. And then we are going to change this into a violin. Now, sometimes you need to play around with the pitch slider to get better results. The flute has quite high frequency, so I'm going to pitch this down 1 octave and press remix. And it's ready. But to make it a little bit more nicer, I'm going to load this sample in my DAW, put some effects on it, and this is the result. Now, that sounds pretty cool, and there is really no limits to this. You can literally use any kind of input you want, and also you can create any kind of AI model. It doesn't necessarily need to be an instrument. You can use sound effects, you can use ambient sounds, animal sounds, you can even combine different kinds of stuff and see what happens. Here are some more examples for you to check out.
Do
So finally, I want to share my own thoughts about this. If you know me well, you know I love real instruments and I have many different ones from all over the world, and I love playing them all. And there is something special and magical about real instruments that is irreplaceable. We often say that an instrument has a soul, and when you play an instrument with real passion, you lose sense of time and place and you go into a deep trance. This is because there is a synergy between you and the instrument. For example, when you play a flute, you use your breath to make sound. You become one with the element. And this is something that will never be replaceable. The second thing that comes in my mind is, how about people that are disabled and can't use their hands to play instruments? But maybe this person has a genius musical mind. A whole new world will open up for them. Suddenly they can play all these instruments just by using their voice. It will be amazing. And if you're really into sound designing like me, you can see that this will open up so many new possibilities to create unique sounds. But I think the most important thing is, as long as the creativity comes from people and we use AI only to extend or enhance our ideas or creativity, we can produce amazing things. However, once AI takes over as a replacement for everything, we'll ultimately become soulless beings incapable of doing anything ourselves. And this is something we definitely should avoid. So I hope you had a great time watching this video and gained some valuable insights from it. I'm really curious what you think and your innovative ideas about what you can create using this. So don't hesitate to spread the word by sharing this video with your friends and others, giving them the chance to explore their creativity too. Thanks for watching and take care. Bye-bye.